I've had a Bridgeport-style mill for years, and it's a great machine. If you need a power feed or a rep or traverse for a machine like this, it's easy to make an adapter for a cordless drill to provide that function. You'll see a lot of these on YouTube machining channels. I made mine from 1/4-inch round bar. It's a simple loop connected to a straight shaft, and I attached a collar to fit over the nut on the handle. This works great for both the X and Y axis. The knee is the hardest part to move, and it sometimes needs to move up or down a foot for different size work pieces. Powering the knee is more challenging, since the handle uses a 9-dog engagement. Of course, a good machinist could make a 9-pin collar, but it's not a trivial job. I wanted to find an effective solution that I could fabricate quickly. My design is based on standard sizes of tubing. I found that 3/4-inch OD tubing with a 1/16th wall is a nice snug fit over the shaft for the handle. I cut this piece 2 1/4 inches long. If you're using welded tubing, you may need to smooth the weld on the inside. Next, I made a spacer from 5/8 OD tubing with a 1/16th wall, which fits inside the 3/4-inch tube perfectly. The shaft for the drill chuck is 1/2-inch round bar, and I cut a piece 1 5/8 inches long. Now I'll weld these together. So the sleeve is finished, and I'll try it into place. It fits perfectly. So I'm going to use a single dog on this to engage the slots, and I'll make that from 3/16 plate. So I'll position this and mark the cut. I'm going to cut this at an angle so the projection is only large on the end where it needs to engage the slot, and it'll be a lower profile toward the rear. So I'll cut this piece and we'll tack it into place. I've cut the dog to size, and I'll try it in place. Looks like it's fitting just perfectly. So now I can weld this to the sleeve. So I have this all clamped up so the dog is centered on the tube, and I'll tack weld it into place. Now I can finish weld this. I'm keeping these welds to a minimum so I don't distort the tubing. So the part is finished. As soon as it cools down, we'll try it out. So here's the finished driver. I added one more feature. I put a tiny weld bead on one part of the shaft so it can't spin on the chuck of the cordless drill. So let's put this into place. And I'll lock the drill onto it, tighten the chuck, and now you can see how this works. Man, that is fantastic. If you've ever tried raising or lowering the knee of a mill with a crank, it's a very slow process, and I love the way this speeds the work. So this is a very simple fabrication. It really doesn't require much in the way of machine work at all, just cutting and welding some tubing and plate, and it makes a very effective adapter to easily raise and lower the knee of your mill. I love making these videos, and I'm honored that you're watching. Please like, subscribe, and click the bell to be notified about new videos. I read every comment, and I do my best to answer all questions. If you like what I'm doing, please click the Patreon link and become one of the great people who help me create new videos. I'll see you next time.